Hi viewers, welcome to LMS Solution. Today we are going to see about EV charging station with the PV, wind and battery energy storage. This is like a DC microgrid or a DC grid. In DC grid, we are going to use this structure for EV charging. So this is a simulation model we developed for EV charging station with the PV, wind and battery energy storage system. So this model consists of wind energy system and the wind turbine and the PMSG, and is going to be connected to the diode rectifier, and then we have a boost converter. So this boost converter going to be controlled by means of P2MPPT. So this P2MPPT going to be received two input. One is rectifier voltage and the rectifier current, and then it going to be process that force set of Ifton rule inside that P2MPPT. When you click inside here, we need to do this four set of rule for calculating the duty cycle. That means you have to calculate a DP and a DV. Based upon this condition, we need to decide duty cycle, whether you are going to increment the duty cycle or decrement the duty cycle. Based upon that condition, it will be generated the duty cycle. So that duty cycle will be a process wave pendulum generator, and it going to be generate the pulse, and this pulse going to be control this boost converter to extract the maximum power from the wind turbine system. Here we are using around 3 kilowatt wind turbine system. There mean 2.5 to 3 kilowatt wind turbine system. This boost converter and MPPT going to be extract the maximum power from the wind turbine. And next we are having PV panel here. So here PV panel rated at 2000 watts. At 1000 watts per meter square, that it can generate around 2 kilowatt power. The voltage up to 45.6 volts. And it going to be connected to the DC link. This is DC link via this boost converter. Both that wind turbine boost converter and PV boost converter going to be connected in the DC link. DC link here we are going to maintain 400 volt. PV will be generated 2 kilowatt and 245 volt at the standard test condition, that means 1000 watts per meter square and 25 degrees Celsius. And wind also it going to be maintained around 240 to 300 volt, then it will be step up to 400 volt along with that MPPT. The same way PV also, the terminal voltage will be 245 volt and the DC link voltage is 400. This boost converter will be boost that voltage from 245 to 400, and also it going to be extractive max. That means this boost converter going to be work along with that incremental conductance MPPT. So this incremental conductance MPPT receive two input. One is PV voltage and current. And then inside we have to check the incremental conductance MPPT equation. So these are the Ifton rules for that incremental conductance MPPT. Here we need to check DV, DI, and then you have to check that incremental conductance condition DI by DV equal to minus I by V. So based upon these conditions, we need to increment or decrement the duty cycle. And based upon that condition, we'll be calculate the duty cycle, and it going to be process via pendulum generator. So this pendulum generator will be generate the pulse. This pulse going to be used to control this boost converter to extract the power from the PV array. So next process, we need to maintain DC link voltage constant. For that, here we are using battery energy storage. The battery energy storage here, the this is like a stationary battery in the EV charging station. So it will be charged any excess power in the system. That means wind and PV is generating excess power. Then it will be take the charge for that means charging during that excess power. When that wind and PV is not generating power, then the battery will be going for discharging mode to supply the EV power and demand. For that, here we are using a stationary battery. And also this the another important using the stationary battery, we need to maintain the DC link voltage constant at 400 volt. So here we are using a bidirectional converter. It will be operating both direction for charging discharging the battery according with the power balance in the system. And here we are measuring the DC link voltage. So here we are measuring DC link voltage, and then it going to be compared with the 400 volt, and the error voltage will be processed via PA controller. The PA controller will be generate the duty cycle to maintain the DC link voltage at around 400. After the duty cycle will be processed via pendulum generator. That pendulum generator will be generate the pulse. This pulse going to be used to control this bidirectional converter. So this bidirectional converter will be do the two operation. One is it going to be maintain the DC link voltage at around 400 volt, and also it will be allow the power flow in the both direction for charge the battery and discharge the battery. And here you see that we can measure different measurements. So I will show that one. PV measurement and then battery measurement. This is inside rectifier power and load power, and we have DC load, then DC bus measurement, and next we have EV battery. Here we have EV battery, so I will explain EV battery data also. Two EV battery we are using. So here we are using EV battery voltage, current and EV power for charging. And here we have SOC of the battery, storage battery, stationary storage battery. Here we are using EV battery. See, that mean here we are connecting two EV battery. It receiving, and that mean this voltage will be, DC link voltage will be 400. The battery voltage we are consider is 320. This storage battery is around 240 and 40 DH. Initial state of charge will be 50. The same kind of battery we are consider for EV. 320 volt, the EV battery voltage will be 320, and then rated capacity will be 22 kilowatt hour. So we are using two battery, 320, 22 kilowatt hour, and then here we are using buck converter. So this buck converter going to be used to control this power of EV charging. Here we are providing the charging power in terms of current. That means here we are going to charge this battery at around 1.5 kilowatt. Just you have to divide that 1.5 kilowatt divided by 400, then we will get the charging current. And we are measuring the charging, that means input charging current from that converter. Then you have to subtract that reference with this current, and it process via PA control, and it will be generated, that means duty cycle, that going to be processed via PA, it will be generated, then it will be generate the pulse for this buck converter. So here we have PA controller. PA controller act as a current controller for to charging that EV battery. Same kind of control will be used for second battery also. Both the EV battery will be charge around 1.5 kilowatt. This EV battery detail, and already told right different measurements. So here here we are changing the irradiation. So every 0.3 second we are changing irradiation from 1500 and 10 watt per meter square, and then 500 1000 watts per meter square. And here we are changing the wind speed from 12 meter per second to 10.8 meter per second at the time of 2 seconds, and then we have to check the power extraction from the wind side, and we have to check the parameter. All that mean first you have to check the PV and then battery and then wind, and we have to check the EV and two EV battery charging, and then finally you have to check the power balance. So here you see that the PV power extracting around 2000 watts at 1000 watts per meter square. After that it changed to 500 watts per meter square. So it will be extracting around 1000 watts during this seconds. 0.621 is generating around 0 watts because irradiation changed to 10 watts per meter square. Again it changed to 500 and then again changed to 1000. So it will be generating around 1000 watts and 2000 watts at 500 watts per meter square and 1000 watts per meter square. And here you see that this power generation from the wind operating at 12 meter per second, so extracting around 3 kilowatt. And here you see that initially it will be battery, storage battery going for charging. So from 0.6 to 1 second, right, it going for discharging. From 1 to 1.6 again it comes to charging, because and the charging happened because of the excess power available in the system. And here you see that this EV voltage, current and battery, that means power, EV voltage, EV current and EV power, charging power. Charging happen around 1.5 kilowatt for both EV battery. This is second EV voltage, EV battery voltage, current and power. And you will see here that variation of different power, PV power and power and battery power, EV charging power. This accumulated power of 2 EV, it charge around 3 kilowatt. According to that, charging happened constantly at EV battery side, and battery storage battery power going for charging, discharging according with the power generation from the PV and wind. And also you will see that graph for storage battery. Here you see that this SOC of the storage battery is initially keep on charging. From this point to this point it going for discharging, because and the power generation from the PV wind will be is less than that EV battery power demand. This will be comes for discharging, and then after 1 second again the power generation from the PV wind will be exceed the EV power demand, then it will be going for a charging. So this is the working of that EV charging station with the PV wind battery energy storage. Thanks for watching our videos, and kindly subscribe our channel and also click bell icon for notification about upcoming videos. Thank you so much. Bye bye.